You can now support my channel by making any purchase through the Gaijin store using my affiliation link. Check out the link in the description below. Let's get this tutorial started, shall we? Before we begin, I would like to point out that I have previously created a tutorial on how to play old replays in War Thunder. A lot has changed since then, and unfortunately that tutorial has now been deprecated and unlisted. But you can still access it in the video description if you would like to learn how to run replay files using download links. For the first step, I must stress that it is highly important, and if you don't follow it, this method will not work. You must have a matching client version. You must have a matching client version. By this, I mean that if your replay was recorded in, say, version 1.95, then you must have a game client of version 1.95. If your game client version does not match that version, then you will receive an error stating as such. For the second step, if your replay file is not located within the backed up War Thunder client, please copy it there, preferably in the replays folder. In the third step, we will need to disable Easy Anti-Cheat if it is enabled in your backed up War Thunder client. To do this, we go to the config.bak file located in the root War Thunder folder. We then open it and change the following line or add it in the top section of the file. Use underscore EAC colon B equals no. Once that's done, save the .blk file and close it. And now for the fourth step. Go to your backed up War Thunder client and navigate to the Win32 or Win64 folder. Next, click on the navigation bar at the top and write down CMD. This will open up the command prompt screen directly in the folder you are currently browsing, a much more sophisticated method than manually navigating with it. And in the fifth and final step, we will write down the following: aces.exe spacebar dash replay spacebar. Next, you will need to write down the path to the replay file based on its location in the root War Thunder folder. Since we put it in the replays folder, that's exactly where our path should be. Backslash replays backslash. Then, copy and paste the replay file name and write down .wrpl. Finally, press enter, and that should launch your War Thunder client and then load the replay. And that should be all. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Also, I would like to thank Gaijin Entertainment for accepting me into their partnership program. I highly recommend anyone who qualifies to contact them and join the program. It's one of the better ones I've seen around in the gaming industry, and I cannot express how happy I am to be a part of it. Until next time, thanks friends, see you again!